Welcome to Hyperledger Kochi Org Book Meetup. So Kochi Org Book is a community initiative that aims to bring in the concept of decentralized identity to reality. It is based on Hyperledger Indy, which focuses on self-sovereign identity management. Today's agenda is a quick overview of Kochi Org Book project, followed by demos on Copman and email verification service. This meeting will be recorded and uploaded to Hyperledger YouTube. So I now invite the Kochi Org Book team to deliver the session.
Thank you, Nikhil. Hello, good evening, everyone. A warm welcome to our session. Let me introduce myself. My name is Eric Joy. I am part of the Wipro Cybersecurity and Risk Services team. I am a community member of the Kochi Org Book initiative as well. I have Arun Suresh and Sumodh Rajan George with me today. Can you guys introduce yourself, please?
Yeah, thank you, Eric. Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is Arun. I'm a part of Wipro Cybersecurity and Risk Services team, and I'm also community member of Kochi Org Book initiative.
Everyone, good evening. My name is Sumit George. It's a part of the Wipro's cybersecurity and services team, and also an active contributor to the Kochi Org Book initiative.
Thank you, Sumit. Thank you, Arun. The agenda for today's session is the overview on Kochi Org Book initiative, then the demo on KOB MAN utility, demo on email verification service, and later on Q&A sessions. The objective of this session is to introduce you all to the Kochi Org Book initiative. We are looking for community members who are interested to contribute. This is a pure community initiative and the first of its kind from Wipro. Let me start with an overview on Kochi Org Book initiative. All of us have digital identities and we use them to build new relationships, encase existing relationships. Today, many sites permit us to log in using Gmail ID or Facebook ID. It is a convenient way for us as we do not need to remember passwords for all our relationships. Well, it has provided convenience for us to build new relationships and avail new service offering. I would like all of you to think through on these lines and let us know. Is it safe to use it? One second. Are we exposing too much information from our end to the likes of Google and Facebook? What all do they know about me? Is it limited to what I have just shared with them or anything more? Do we really own our digital identity? These digital identity management systems are centralized in nature. A single entity has full control on managing our identity information. They decide what information to share and how to share it. This takes the control from our hands to manage our identity details. As a solution to these issues, we are focusing on decentralized identity management leveraging Hyperledger Indy and Aries, which enable individuals to manage their identity information using consent management. We are not discussing about Hyperledger Indy and Aries in this session, as it can be done in a separate session. Kochi Org Book is a verifier organization network for the city of Kochi. This is a modeling from the government of British Columbia's the Org Book initiative. This initiative is the production, and the Canadian government is extending this to other provinces of Canada. The objective of this initiative was to enable business entities to avail permits or licenses from the government in a transparent and efficient manner. In Kochi, these are many associations, and in the current form, it may not be feasible from an ordinary citizen to confirm it, confirm if the associations are valid or not. We often trust the documents they present. As you know, today's documents are being forged, and it is quite easy to misguide anyone using the forged documents. With Kochi Orbook initiative, each association will now be able to present digitally credentials, which has been issued to them from a trusted entity and can be verified by the any citizen of Kochi using their mobile wallet app. Kochi Orbook is a technology demonstrator to launch an DID, decentralized identity based utility compliant with the TOIP standards to enable trusted digital verification service for various associations within the city of Kochi. We can schedule a separate session on TOIP foundation later on. Today, to avail a service, we need to share a lot of documents to provide our identity. Our eligibility, etc. Often the whole process takes time and lot of our effort to follow through till we secure the approval. This utility aims to cut down the red tape and improve the overall efficiency of the current process. Internet scale digital trust with close to 1 million digital credentials on the network. Next, let us discuss on key use cases for Kochi Orbook. Medical practitioner. Getting an expert opinion is not an easy thing today. KOB would permit a citizen to identify a doctor with specific expertise and secure their consultation service without compromising on their privacy. Lawyers. Similar approach to be leveraged in this case as well. Driving license. Ability for an individual to prove his eligibility to attend a driver's license test. Issuing mark sheets. Enable universities to verify the credentials shared by the student to confirm the eligibility for admission to a course offered by the university. Next, we will discuss about the generic use cases for KOB, which will exist in all of the use cases which we just discussed. Search association organization. The initial actor can be credential requester. A credential requester enters search criteria and is returned a list of association matches based on the criteria. Another use case is verify credentials. The initial actor can be claim requester. The claim requester selects the association and the type of the claim and request verification. Kochi Orbook sends the request to the sovereign blockchain node, which verifies the request and returns the verification information to Kochi Orbook. Kochi Orbook then presents the verified claims to the claim requester. The next use case can be revoke credentials. The initial actor can be associations here, in this case KOB registry. At any point, the claim issuer may revoke a previously issued claim and send a request to the update the ledger in order to revoke a specific claim. The next use case is issuing credentials. Here also the actor can be association. At a predetermined time, an association's KOB registry will forward new public data as a CSV extract to a drop location where it is picked by KOB Bootstrap tool and convert it to JSON format. KOB agent retrieves the files and loads new association information into Kochi Orgbook's searchable database and add verifiable credential into the association's wallet. If you take a look at the picture here on the right, you'll be able to see the generic use cases, the pictorial representation of generic use case that I just explained earlier. The benefits are QB is decentralized in nature, process building trust among participants, cuts red tape and improve efficiency, display public data in verifiable and authentic manner, empowers individual or entity to manage its identity. If you take a look on the next slide, you'll be able to see the Kochi Orgbook sub projects. Kochi Orgbook, the Orgbook for the city of Kochi. KOB Connect, wallet application for KOB users. KOB Registry, the base code to set up a KOB registry. KOB Dflow, KOB decentralized workflow for KOB. KOB Man, KOB Man CLI for managing the KOB projects. KOB WAN, WAN network for the city of Kochi on top of sovereign Hyperledger Entity. The below is listed the links to each of this project. You'll be able to redirect to the specific projects via the link. Next is the community groups. We have actually divided the community side into four different categories. One for developers, the next one for DevOps engineers, the third one is for solution designing and domain, and fourth is the community. If you take a look on the slide, you'll be able to see the activities of each domain and the requirement, the skill set that is required for each of the domain. For instance, for developers, if they are working on KOB Connect project, the skill set that is required here is Android app or Angular skill set. For KOB Dflow and WAN, Python, Django, all these kinds of skill set are required. Likewise, for DevOps, solution designing for community, the skill set that has been required is listed there. If you take a look on the activities for the developers, code refactoring, enhancements, issue fixing. For DevOps engineers, code integration, CI/CD, GitHub. For solution designing, identify potential business use cases and documenting them. For community contribution, all of these activities are involved. We are actually welcoming the contributors here. Current status of KOB project is, we have created the repos for the KOB project in the GitHub. Features has been captured and put in as the product backlogs here. Features tracks as issues under specific project repos. Identified few community members, teams being onboarded to work on each specific project for KOB initiative. Initiated work on some feature leveraging the community members. How to contribute to KOB? Participation in events hosted by Hyperledger Kochi community for KOB. Participation in local hackathons. Pick up issues and start submitting pull requests against various KOB code repositories. Participate in use case modeling workshop for KOB. With this, we conclude our first part of the session. We will now proceed with the demo sessions, then take up on the questions. I hope this is fine with everyone. Let me call upon Arun to walk through the demo on KOB Man utility. Over to Arun.
Hello, everyone. So we'll be doing a demo on the KOB Man CLI, which is a command line utility for the Kochi Orgbook initiative. And then we have also built a verification service called KOB email verification service. We are planning to play the video, recorded videos of these two. So Sumod will be the one who's playing it. Sumod. The KOBman utility. So what KOBman utility does is that it's an easy way of installing all that environments that we just saw. Since these environments are having a certain number of steps that you should really follow to bring it up. And it can be a little bit tough for someone with no previous experience. So KOBman utility clears that with just a simple setup installation and installation. You can just type in a command and then install all those environments for yourself with ease. Sumod, hello. Can you hear me? Yeah, thank you. So this is a way of confirming that the KOB code installed. Now, KOB minus P just gives out the utilities version 003. The next command is the KOB list command, which lists out all the environments that the KOBman utility can install. And they have also listed down all the versions available for the those environments. Now we have listed down KOBman as well as Aries Dev. The KOBman is a dev environment for the KOBman CLI, which actually helps you to which actually creates a dev environment for you in your own, under your namespace, so that a developer can work on issues or a new feature set with ease. Aries Dev is the Aries Cloud Agent Python project. Now the next command would be to install. Hello, am I audible now? Yeah, sorry about that. Sumod, please continue the video. Okay, so the next command is to install these environments. So to install, we just have to type in the install command, which is kob install. Sumat, can you please play the video? Yeah, thank you. Kob install minus env, then mention the environment that you want to install, kob man, then the version that you want to install, minus v, and 003, which is the latest version available. Now, once we run that, we'll be prompted to give the user's namespace, which is your GitHub ID, so that KobMan can create a fork of Kob from Hyperledger Kochi into your name, under your namespace. And the dev environment will be created from your own forked version of KobMan. So once you've exported that, and we'll run the command again. So right now it didn't prompt you for that, but it says installing Hub, which is an extension of GitHub. Now Hub is used to fork the KobMan repository into your own namespace. And that could take a while depending on your network speed. So please do bear with us.
just want to check if this video is audible for everyone.
Yes, sure.
Yeah. Are we having an issue with the? Okay. Yeah. Let me just share it from my end.
Okay. Thank you.
So now that we are done with the Cubeam and CLI, hope you are able to see my screen.
Yes, sir.
Okay then.
In this session, we will discuss about service for engineering education service and followed by that service. You know that in the digital world, human ID is an important part of your identity. User identity is an initiative, connection, the service connection, as well as connection information. Now, a few of them are missing. Now, what is a connection? A connection is a token issued by an authorized entity, and it helps us to prove our identity with our request, just like your other card, your driving license. Now, in the digital world,
thank
my screen is visible to all, in this demo, I will be using a mobile wallet called Tensic, which will be enabling me to store the encrypted digital credential for my email ID and share that with my connections as required. On my screen, you can now see the page of our email verification service. You need to enter your email ID in this page and click submit. Once you click submit, a response will be sent to the shared email ID. You can view the same in my mail dev page. This is done for demonstration purpose. Now you should be able to see the message from the service in my mailbox. To proceed further, I need to click on the link provided in my mailbox. By clicking it, a new page will be opened. It will have a QR code. I need to scan the QR code using my mobile wallet app, which is on the right side of the screen. Hope you can see the screen of my mobile wallet app on the screen. Now, I am scanning the QR code using the wallet app. To establish a connection between the email verification service and my mobile wallet app. There are two things happening here. One, it can prove that I am in ownership of the shared email ID. Second thing is that this provides me the ability to establish a connection with the email service and mobile wallet app. This is a peer-to-peer connection that will get created between the service and please wait while the platform process completes. Now you can see on my wallet app that I received a notification. Let me click it, and now you can see that I have received the credential from the email verification service, like I say on the wallet app. I'm going to accept it. The credential that is created now can be used in any other service that is using the same technology. That's it for the demo. Thank you.
I don't know how much clear the audio was for you guys. Can you just please confirm like how much you are able to listen to? Was it clear enough or? Okay. So, if there are any questions from your end,
can I ask one question, please?
Yeah, sure. Can you please state your name, please?
Hi, my name is Nirupam.
Okay. Hi, Nirupam. Can you state your question?
What is KOBCLI?
Okay, it's a Bash shell scripts based project that we created for the purpose of setting up the new projects for it will be if we created if we set up a new project, we'll be able to identify all the steps, right? So once we identify these steps, we will be categorizing it to one of the environment. And once we identify it as an environment, we can add it to the QoB project. So that from next time onwards, if some developer is trying to set up the same environment, right, he will be able to do that just in a jiffy, like by using a command like a KOB minus env install that project's name. So it's for the developers mainly for setting up the project.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So folks, we really apologize. Like we don't know why exactly the audio was not really clear. We'll try to make it up for the next time. So any more questions?
Yeah, it was a good session, Eric. So can you just explain what the email service actually does in a short 1 minute, so that because the audio was not, we couldn't hear that video, what you are doing in that video.
Yeah, of course. Like the QoB email verification service, it's actually an Aries based project. It has an Aries agent beneath it. So what we just did was like by using the QR code, we established a connection. If you are aware of what an Aries agent does, is it's actually for for making the DAD based exchanges. The Aries agent is required. Okay, so in this project, the Aries agent, we establish a connection with an Aries agent. With that connection, we are not really doing anything here. For that, like for using that established connection, they're using the credential. If we there was some other project that was using the same Aries agent, we might have been able to verify the credential that we created. In this project, we just simply created it. Okay. So I don't know how much the audience is aware about the Aries part.
Okay, Nikhil, just to clarify, right, what we're trying to do here is we're trying to actually create decentralized services which can be leveraged to actually issue credentials for certain credential proofs for certain credentials. Right now, if you look at it in any online registration form, you will have, you know, you have to submit your phone number, you'll have to submit your email IDs, you'll have to submit your address details, etc., etc. Now what we're trying to do is we're trying to actually build separate out each of these credentials, having a separate decentralized service, leveraging the Aries cloud agent capabilities for the system to actually verify your address details or your phone number details or your email, and issue a proof stating that you are the ownership, you are the trusted owner of this particular phone number or the email number, or if the address that you have shared is a valid address. Now this could be a credential which you can actually later on leverage to, you know, for establishing, for let's say, for example, if you have an entity which is already on border as part of the an EDID based network, and they have their registration process being made as an online service available on the DID network, then definitely this would give you an opportunity for you to actually share these credential proof and help you to establish your identity without actually sharing your information in a plain text format. So as part of that initiative, that scope, right, we have actually decided to break down some of the basic credential information into a set of series of independent decentralized services for offering credential proof. So one of them is actually the email verification service that which we just showed.
Okay, I think that made the point clear about the email verification service. So are there any other queries regarding the demo or in general about Kochi Orgbook project? So if anyone have anything to, any queries, you can ask now.
Just to reiterate, right, Kochi Orgbook project is more of a technology demonstrator to showcase the capability of how DID can actually enable associations to have their own, freedom and vote themselves as a verifiable organization. And our, the citizens in a, in a jurisdiction or like a city like Kochi will be able to avail various services using their credential proofs that have been issued to them, and avail services in a secure manner whereby there is no compromise to their privacy. Today, what happens is any online digital service that you have to avail, you have to share them a lot of your personal information. And by default, many of them ask you a lot of information which may not be really required for you to really avail the service. But the problem with that is you end up sharing a lot of your personal information in a plain text format. And you have absolutely no idea how this data is going to be stored in the database of the report of the service provider. What what kind of security mechanism does a person employ to ensure that your data is not being passed on to someone else? And I'm sure all of you on this call are very much aware of the mess up that Facebook had done with, you know, a lot of personal information being, you know, shared with third party vendors, which had resulted in, you know, a lot of people losing their privacy to external entities. So the objective of the KFB is going to help, you know, establish and showcase the benefits that you can actually avail by having setting up a DID-based network and enabling and empowering the citizens to actually manage their identity, which in today's digitalization world, it is of utmost importance. We have, you know, government bodies across the world, you know, formulating various policies and legal you know, procedures to ensure that the privacy of citizens are maintained and it is not being compromised for availing any kind of digital services.
Okay, so if any of the participants have any questions, they can ask now.
We already have our code available in GitHub. It is hyperledger.kochi/KOB. So it's available. You guys can take a look at it. In fact, under hyperledger.kochi namespace and GitHub, we have quite a number of projects that we have actually, you know, included, which is part of the overall scope of KOB. You guys can take a look at it. Right now, we're focusing on KOB Man project, and then the other part that we're focusing is on creation of these decentralized services.
Okay, so if anyone want to join the Hyperledger Kochi org book project, it's a community initiative. So anyone can participate in the community initiative and be part of the org book project. I think we have covered almost everything regarding the demo. So Sumod, if it's fine, then can we conclude the session?
Yeah, I mean, if anyone has any questions that you would like to drop us a mail, you can reach out to Nikhil. He has got our email IDs. So feel free to drop us a mail if you have any questions. I'm sure you may not, extremely apologize for the audio quality that we had today.
Okay, so one question is if there is any process for joining the org book project. So
do send us a mail. We'll help you get onboarded, right?
So can you share your email?
Yeah, I'll put it in the chat window.
Yeah, sure. I'll do that. Okay, then that was a wonderful session on Kochi org book project. So it's an exciting community initiative based on Hyperledger Indy. And we saw the demo on KOB Man and email verification service. So I hope we can collaborate further on when you have some other, exceeded or gone through another phase in your development phase, then we can have another demo on some other initiative that you have done on Kochi org project. So
definitely, yep. We really want to have more sessions with you, but I think, unfortunately, just a suggestion. Can we plan something on the weekend? I mean, I know it might be of inconvenience to people, but at least I think we can definitely do away with these sort of, you know, network related issues which is impacting the column.
Yeah, audio quality. We can all do that. Definitely, we can include it in the weekends if it is okay for the presenters also.
Yeah, so, yeah, sure. But I think that should help us, because usually what we are seeing is towards the evening, you know, at times we encounter, you know, network issues, and that is kind of, and it disrupts the audio quality as well. So if,
okay.
Once again, let me extend our, you know, apology for that.
Yeah, it's no issues for now. We have seen the demo, and it was a nice demo, and we had a wonderful session, and we had the clarification also. So that's all for this session. So I will end it here. And you can all, I think we will gather again in another day, and we will share the progress of Kochi Orgbook project.
And Nikhil, thanks once again for hosting this session for us, so that we could, you know, get initiated at least on, you know, get people to know what Kochi Orgbook is all about. Definitely, we'll have other sessions as well, and that'll help you guys to get up to speed on what we intend to do, where we are progress so far, and how you'll be able to contribute back to this community initiative. All right. Okay.
Sure.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Yeah.
Thanks. Bye.
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 Thank you.